I came home from playing tennis, as I said before. My wife was like this, and I was hoping that I wasn't the one she was looking like that about. And I went up to her and I kissed her on the cheek. I said, "How you feeling, Pud?" She said, "I want you to go upstairs and kill that boy." And I said, "Right." Because I was happy. I wasn't the one in trouble. "Kill the boy, kill the boy." "Yes, master, yes, master." So I go to kill my son. He was in the room, looking pitiful. And I can understand that, because my mother sent me to the room many times. "Your father comes home, he's going to shoot you in the face with a bazooka. And I am not going to stop him this time either. You know, he's always wanted to kill you. The day you were born, he said, 'Kill it.' I stopped him from killing you for 11 years. And this is the thanks I get for saving your life." I looked at him, I said, "Your mother sent me here to kill you." He said, "Uh-huh." I looked at him, and I noticed that on top of his head, from here all the way around to here, there was no hair. So I said, "Son?" Called him son. I said, "What happened to your hair?" He said, "I don't know." I said, "Son, take your hand and put it on top of your head and tell me what you feel." He said, "There's no hair." I said, "Right. Now, tell Dad what happened to your hair." He said, "I don't know." I said, "Son, was your head with you all day today?" He said, "Uh-huh." I said, "Did you cut your hair off?" He said, "Uh-huh." I said, "Then why didn't you tell me that?" He said, "I don't know." I said, "Is this the hairstyle you wanted?" He said, "Uh-huh." I said, "A reversed mohawk?" So I went back downstairs. My wife said, "Did you kill him?" I said, "No." She said, "Why?" I said, "I don't know."